Hi everyone, my name is Jake, and today I'd like to share tool tips and tricks on adding and using 3D assets to your comic pages. This video is not about creating 3D assets, but it will cover tips and advice on using basic functions, 3D objects, 3D backgrounds, and character models, and how to convert them into 2D art, all of which can be accomplished in Clip Studio Paint. So first, let's cover the basics. When you're ready to start using assets, you can find all the defaults and downloaded files in your materials folder. Just find the asset you want, then click and drag it onto your page. If you've drawn out panels using the panel tool, you can drag and drop assets directly into them and then manipulate them within the confines of the panel. With the new layer still selected, you can add or take away as many assets as you want in the same scene. Once you've dragged an asset into the 3D space, you can adjust its location on the 3D plane by selecting it and using the arrows and semicircles to manipulate it. The green arrow and line pans and rotates the object on the Z axis, the magenta arrow and line pans and rotates on the X axis, and the blues manipulate the object on the Y axis. The ball in the middle lets you freely manipulate the object relative to your camera view, and the outer gray circle lets you drag to change the size of the object. To reset the model size, angle, or rotation, the buttons are located below where you select the object. When you want to look around the 3D space, you can use the camera buttons above the 3D asset you've selected. Alternatively, you can use your mouse to manipulate your camera. To rotate, hold down your left mouse button. To zoom, hold down your right mouse button and move the cursor either up or down. To pan side to side, hold the middle mouse button. If you have EX, you can open up the All Sides view to get several angles and adjust your scene accordingly. You can access this by having your 3D layer selected, go to Window, and click All Sides view. Take time to play around with these tools, because it can make it much handier to manage objects in the 3D space. So when it comes to 3D assets, there are different types of objects that have very different functions. First, let's talk about the 3D objects and backgrounds. 3D objects can be manipulated across the 3D space, and since version 1.8, the backgrounds are considered 3D objects as well, but may be locked. To unlock them, load in the background object with a V2 in its name, go to the Display, Object List, on the Tool Property palette, and check that the selection is enabled for the 3D object material. Some assets have presets you can toggle, and some even have mobile parts. On the toolbar below, you'll find three buttons: Material Presets, Layout Presets, and Mobility Part Sliders. The material presets can change the look and texture, layout presets can change part visibility and even change the objects themselves, and finally, certain parts can have programmed sliders in the mobility tab where applicable, such as opening doors and moving chairs. Not every asset has a folder full of these presets though. However, every asset has camera presets. The backgrounds most often come with unique presets to help put together your setting. If the camera is blocked off by anything, more often than not, there is a solution in the layout presets that will make it visible. Next, we'll talk about character models, of which there are two types: character material and drawing figures. For our comics, we will only be using drawing figures. These figures are super useful if you need to draw a more complicated pose or a body in difficult perspectives, and they come with drawing guides and adjustable body shapes. You can access these by clicking on the button here, Adjust Body Shape and Size, and you can change anything from the height, the head-to-body ratio, to the physique of the entire body. These figures are operated in the same 3D space as objects and backgrounds, just with many more moving parts. If you click on the figure once, you will see the same tool pop up at the base of the figure, and you will see extra spheres hovering in general locations around the body. Clicking and dragging these spheres lets you freehand parts of the body. When you want to adjust parts more specifically, just click on a part of the figure's body until it is highlighted and the options will appear. Poses can be saved as materials, and there are existing pose materials in your materials folder. If you find a pose you like, you can drag and drop from the materials folder directly onto the 3D figure. If you need to fix something or tweak it in any way, you can still make adjustments after applying. There is also an option to mirror the pose, which is located here near the presets, and even a separate operation to adjust hand poses located in the same subtool as where you found the body sliders. Another cool feature in Clip Studio Paint is the AI posing command, which lets you import a reference photo of a pose for an AI to match on your figure as close as possible. It's excellent for blocking out poses. If you have EX, you can use this next tool, which is LT conversion, accessed by going to Layer, LT conversion. This allows you to easily translate your 3D scene into 2D layers, including separated lines and tone. Make sure to check preview to see what result you'll get as you make adjustments. When you're finished, hit OK, and it will create a new folder with your 2D layers inside. Don't worry if you've made a mistake. The original 3D layer is still there if you need to do it again. All that's left is to draw out your scene with your lovely 3D models as your guide. What's really wonderful about Clip Studio is that all these tools are available by default, and there's a large library of tools made by users for users, all available in the Clip Studio Asset Store. Although I believe ultimately the tools don't make the artist, Clip Studio makes the comic creating process incredibly streamlined and user-friendly for beginners and masters alike. I hope you found this video helpful, and I wish you luck on your comic journey. Thank you for watching, and until next time.